FarmChem's TopShot Injection System is an automated batching system that is designed to inject products into ammonia anhydrous tanks. It comes in a cart with a 115 VAC system, an 8-foot suction hose with a 2-inch female cam lock, a 20-foot discharge hose, and a controller. In this tutorial, we'll walk you through how to set up the TopShot, as well as teach you how to calibrate, change the settings on, and how to use this product. Before assembly, make sure all threaded areas are wrapped with sealant tape to prevent leaks. You can assemble the TopShot with the cover on or off the cart. In this tutorial, we will assemble with the cover off. Some product containers are equipped with a male dry brake. When connecting to those containers, the female dry brake will be required. This tutorial will show installation and connection of the female dry brake. Other product containers will have a 2-inch male cam lock. The TopShot comes with the fittings to connect to those as well. If applicable, start assembly by threading the suction hose into the steel bushing. Now thread the bushing into the female dry brake coupler. Pop the cover off the outlet of the tank and connect the dry brake on the hose to it. Thread the other side of the hose into the suction port of the TopShot and lock in place. When you're ready to pump, you'll need to open both the valve on the outlet of the product container and the valve on the coupler. Next, thread the discharge hose to the discharge port and tighten in place. Install the other end of the discharge hose onto the ammonia anhydrous tank vapor valve, or for priming and calibration, back into the product container. Install the control box in a place easily accessible. Connect the power cord to an outlet. Connect the gray electrical cable to the bottom of the controller and flip the switch on the controller on. Setup is now complete. Now that the pump is on, let's prime it. Key in the pin number and hit enter. Then go down to prime the pump and hit the arrow keys to select a test. Hit enter and then hit 1 to start the prime. After the pump is primed, start the calibration process. Put the discharge hose into a measurable container and hit the clear button on the controller to go back to the main menu. Hit setup and go down to tech mode. Key in your pin, hit enter, and go down to calibration at the bottom of the next menu. Hit enter again, and you'll hear a siren coming from inside the controller. Open the controller, and in the bottom left of the lid, you'll see the calibration jumper. Remove it and reinsert it to stop the siren. Now you get to select your unit of measure. We'll choose gallons, but choose the unit of measure that matches your container. If you haven't primed your pump, do so now. Otherwise, hit enter to move on to the pump calibration menu. On the next menu, hit 1 to start the pump. When it reaches a measurable mark, hit 2 to stop. Enter the amount of liquid pumped and hit enter to complete the calibration process. Now hit clear to go back to the tech menu. We're going to run a test dispense to check for accuracy, so hit clear once more to go to dispense mode. Go to dispense product, then key in the tank number, or leave it blank, and input the amount you want to dispense. Hit start to begin the test. The pump will stop when it reaches that amount. If you want to adjust the calibration number, you can do that too. Hit the setup button and go down to tech mode. Key in the pin code and hit enter on settings. Hit enter once more, then use the down arrow to cycle through the options until you get to press enter to adjust calibration number. Hit enter, then hit 1 to decrease the amount or 2 to increase the amount. Hit enter again, key in the percent change you want, hit enter once more, and you've adjusted the calibration number. You can also enter your early shutoff amount and pulse time in the settings menu. Just find those options, key in your new amount, and hit enter. Lastly, let's change the presets. Hit the setup button and go down to dealer mode. Key in the pin number and hit the arrows on the next menu until you find preset dispense value 1. Hit enter and key in your new value. Then hit enter once more to save your preset to P1. Scroll a little farther down on the menu to find preset 2 and preset 3, and do the same process you did for preset 1 to change these. For more information on the TopShot, please call us at 800-247-1854 or visit shop.farmchem.com.